If you've just had blood tests and your cholesterol levels are high and your doctor is recommending that you go on drugs to lower your cholesterol, so that would be like statins, for example, because your metrics show that you are high risk of cardiovascular disease, so stroke and heart attack, then here is a really crucial piece of information that you need to understand so that you can have a conversation with your doctor so that between the two of you, you make the best decision. Now, I'm not a doctor. This is not medical advice. This is information. I'm a science teacher. I'm going to teach you some science so that you can have that conversation with your doctor. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall, and like I said, I'm not a doctor. I am a nutritionist. I am a scientist, and I'm a science teacher. And I've been looking at the blood test results of a member of our channel who had her blood tests and was horrified when her doctor said she was high risk. She is very slim, she's very active, and the last thing she thought was that she would be at high risk of stroke or heart attack. But the numbers, according to the test, seem to indicate that she is, and her doctor is recommending that she go on a statin. So I'm going to use her numbers. I have a whiteboard over here. I'm going to put her numbers on here so that we can have a look at them and we can see what the numbers are that the doctor is looking at. Then I'm going to show you something else. So let's come over here. This is the lipid test, and here cholesterol, HDL, LDL, and triglycerides. Those are the four things that have come up. Now you can see the references over here. These numbers are the limits according to the insurance companies, okay? According to the pharmaceutical companies. So the pharmaceutical companies have done the research, designed the drug, and then they give these numbers to the doctors as a reference so the doctors know, according to the pharmaceutical companies, when to prescribe the drug. Okay, so look at this one. Overall cholesterol should be below 5.2 millimoles per liter. Now, yours might be in milligrams per deciliter, which is a completely different unit, but no problem. I'm going to put a link down below to a website where you can just plug in your numbers and it will convert to millimoles per liter so that you can have the context. Okay, so we're using millimoles per liter here. This 5.2, sometimes they use 5. Her cholesterol came in at 7.9. That is very high according to this reference. So that was a red flag to her doctor. Her HDL was 2.4. Her LDL, which is sometimes called bad cholesterol, needs to be below 3.4. And look at this, 4.9. Another big red flag. And then her triglycerides came to 1.2. So you can see that her overall cholesterol was way over the reference number. Her LDL was way over the reference number. And that was enough for her doctor to say, clearly you are high risk of heart attack and stroke. Now let's just understand that these numbers are supplied by the pharmaceutical companies, and let's just get it out there. They are the ones who sell the drug. Which is not to say they're lying or that the drugs don't work. Of course they work. But that number, this 5, for example, used to be 7. Then it was 6. Then it was 5.5. Now it's 5. So over the years, the reference number has been coming down. Some would say so that more people can be caught in the net. I don't know about that, but it does seem a bit odd. Anyway, what is interesting, and this is the real point here, there is another group of people, highly, highly qualified, very clever people, actuaries, who specialize in data analysis and calculating risk. And those people are employed by life assurance companies. Because life assurance companies are playing with their money and they constantly have to understand risks when they provide insurance or life assurance to people. And what's really interesting about this person's numbers is if she took these numbers and went to an insurance company and said, I would like to apply for life cover, they would look at these numbers and go, okay, you look great, you are very low risk, we'll give you the cover you want at a really good rate. Now that doesn't sit with the doctor and the pharmaceutical companies saying she's such high risk, she needs to go on lifelong drugs, even with horrible side effects. Somebody is wrong. They can't both be right. She can't be high risk and low risk at the same time. So what are the insurance companies looking at in these numbers that the doctor's not looking at? Let's go back to the board and I'll show you. They don't care about this number here. Not interested. They don't care about this number here. Not interested in that either. The insurance companies do not rely on the pharmaceutical companies to teach them how the science works. They want to understand it themselves because they really, really have to know where they're putting their money. So they look at the data, they look at the research, they look at the up-to-date research to really, really understand who's going to have high risk of heart disease and who is not. They're not trying to sell anything. And what they look at is a couple of ratios that they get from these numbers. So here we go. The first one they do is cholesterol divided by HDL. And here's the reference the insurance companies use. Anything between 3.5 and 5 is sort of normal and healthy. Above 5 is high risk, unhealthy, they don't want to insure you. If you get below 3.5, you are their perfect client. This person's number is 3.3. That's a big green light to the insurance companies. She is very, very low risk of a heart attack. But that's not the only one they look at. They also look at triglycerides. Okay, these are blood fats that have come from sugar. So if you have too much sugar in your diet, your triglyceride number goes up. And that, those are dangerous. So they take your triglycerides, divided by your HDL number, and they want to see a number anywhere between 1 and 2. If it's over 2, you're very high risk. If it's below 1, you are super healthy, and please, can we just insure you? Her numbers come out at 0.5. So in both the metrics that the life assurers use, she is super healthy, super low risk, and their ideal client, and they want to throw money at her at the same time that her doctor and the pharmaceutical companies are saying she's very high risk and she needs to buy this drug. This is a conversation to have with your doctor. I'm not saying anybody's lying. I think they're using the data differently and they're interpreting it differently. I think the drug companies are conflicted because they really do need to sell their drug. The insurance companies, they don't want to risk their money. They're not stupid. They are not going to insure her if they think she's high risk. And yet, according to how they calculate the results, she's very, very low risk. It's just really interesting. And I would stress that you need to have this conversation with your doctor. Now, I'm putting links down below to some research, other videos that you can go and watch to understand how it works. It looks very strange to me. The latest research does show that cholesterol numbers are actually not relevant. Heart disease, stroke, heart attacks are a result of sugar abuse, high insulin, high inflammation. It's got nothing to do with fat or dietary fat or cholesterol. I made a video about cholesterol so that you can understand what cholesterol is. If you want to watch that, that's probably going to be quite useful, because what is cholesterol? We talk about it all the time and we don't even know what it is. So I would recommend that you watch that video just to get a handle of what it actually means and where it comes from. And then I would say, before you go on a statin, understand your blood profile numbers so that you can make the decision. And here's a tip, here's a clue. I've many times encountered people being told like this, that their numbers are high and they need to go on a statin. And the moment they say, oh, I don't know if I want to, I'm surprised, I didn't think I was unhealthy, I don't like the idea of the side effects, the doctors go, okay, all right, up to you. Now that worries me. There are two reasons that I can think of why the doctor would react like that, and I don't think either of them are good. Either the doctor doesn't really care whether you do or not. Well, that's bad. I don't want a doctor who doesn't care. Or the doctor knows that you don't really need it. They're recommending it because that's what the guidelines say and that's what the drug companies say. They know in their heart of hearts you're actually quite healthy and you don't actually need it. So the moment you say, oh, well, I don't know, I think I'd rather not, they go, okay, fine, up to you. I'd be very suspicious. You need to have this conversation with your doctor. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you for subscribing. And please share this video. Let's get that message out there. Let's get the knowledge out there that it's not just the drug companies that should be deciding whether you should buy their drugs or not. All right. Thank you very much for your time.